Good afternoon, one and all. So today let us see the diversion head works. The diversion head works, which is constructed at the head of the canal in order of divert the river water towards the canal. So this concept you will very well known about this, so as ensure the regulator continuous supply of silt free water with the certain minimum head into the canal is known as diversion head works. So what are the objectives? The objectives are to first to raise the water level to the head of the canal. Second is to form a storage by constructing dikes, that is the embankment on both banks of the river, so that water is available throughout the year. And third objective is to control entry of silt into the canal and control the deposition of the silt head of the canal. And last is to control the fluctuation of the water level in the river during different seasons. Right now, these are the objectives. So selection of site for diversion work, head work. The first is at the site, the river should have straight and narrow. And second is the river bank should be well defined. Third is the valuable land should not be submerged when the weir is barges construction. And the elevation of the site should be much higher than the area to be irrigated. Then fourth is the site should be easily accessible by roads and railways. The material of construction should be available vicinity of the area. The site should not be far away from the command area of the project. Then weir and barges. It is a barrier constructed across the river, raise the water level of the upstream side of the obstruction in order to the feed or main canal. The ponding of water can be achieved either by only a raised crest across the river or by a raised crest supplement of gates or shutters working over the crest. So this is an typical layout of weir without shutters and weir with shutters. This is the weir without shutters. This is the crest level is equal to pond level, and the total ponding by wrist and crest, this is the difference. And P1 is equal to P and P2 is equal to 0. There is weir without shutters. And this one, the weir with shutters, what is the P1 to pond level. So in between that, the ponding of crest shutters and ponding by the raised crest. And this is the crest shutter, crest level and total ponding. So these are the example diagrams. Then figure barrage with the small raised crest and barrage without any raised crest. This is an barrage with small raised crest, and this is the barrage without the raised crest. Weir. If the major part of the entire ponding of the water is achieved by the raised crest and smaller part or nail part of which is achieved by the shutters, then the barrier is known as weir. So this is a typical cross section modern concrete weir. You very well known about. Actually, this is the pond level. And this one is the discharge sloping glacis on which the hydraulic jump. This is the apron conditions or the falling apron. This is the downstream sheet pile lines. And this is the packed stones, aprons. And these are the sheet piles. Gravity or non-gravity weirs. When the weight of the weir of the body and floor balances upward pressure caused by the head of the water seeping below the weir is called gravity weir. Then on the other hand, if the weir flood is designed continuous with the divide piers as a reinforced structure such that weight of concrete slab together with the weight of divide piers keep the structure safe against the uplift, and the structure may be called as non-gravity weirs. In the other case, RCC is to be used a place to brick piers. Considerable savings may become obtained as the weight of the floor can be much less than what is the required of the gravity wear. Types of wears. The first is masonry wear, that is the masonry wear which is vertical drop, rock fill wears with the sloping aprons, concrete wear with sloping glaciers. Masonry wear. Masonry wear with vertical drop. Masonry wear wall constructed over the impervious floor. It is the pond level and it is constructed over the impervious floor. Cut-off wall provided the both ends of the floor. That is the cut-off wall. That is a cut-off wall provided both end of the pier walls. Piers. The crease shutters provided raise of the water level. The crease shutters provided raise of the, that is the water level, and it is the crease shutter raise of the water level if required. The shutters are dropped down during flood. The masonry wear wall may be a vertical both face. The masonry wall vertical on both face or sloping both face or vertical downstream face, sloping upstream face. And this is an actual masonry wear diagram. The rock fill wears with sloping aprons. It consists of masonry breast wall which is provided adjustable crease shutters. It is a crease shutter, adjustable crease shutters. The upstream rock fill portion constructed with boulder forming. It is the upstream portion and this is the downstream portion. And the upstream rock fill portion constructed with boulders forming slope of 1:4. And the boulder are grouted with cement mortar. These are the boulder grouted with cement mortar. The downstream sloping consists of core walls. The intermediate spaces between the core walls filled up with the boulder maintaining slope, that is 1:20. The boulder is grouted properly with cement mortar. Then concrete wear. This is a concrete wear. Nowadays the concrete wear considered constructed with reinforced cement concrete. The impervious floor of the wear is made up of monolithic. The cutoff walls is provided upstream of the downstream end of the floor and the toe of the wear. This is a downstream wall. Upstream toe wall, this is the crease shutter strut and this is the wear portion and these are the sheet files. The crease shutters are also provided with the drop down during the flood. Barrage. It is the most ponding done by the gates and smaller and nil part of the done by the raised crest. Then barrier is known as barrage or river regulator. So this is the HFL level, this is the pond level, actual pond level. This is an CC block section, it is inverted filter, this is an apron, this is a discharge portion of protection, this is a, both are the sheet piles and it is also apron part. So it is a typical cross section of barrage. Thank you.